Hello, Banjo, last one. Steve.
That's not Banjo, that's some big bird thing.
Oh. George.
Here we are. At last.
Did Kazooie turn into a big bird? Oh, that's not Kazooie.
No, that's everybody's favorite Banjo-Kazooie character, Canary Mary.
The best character in the game.
Yeah, and
you mentioned her in the last game, in the last thing I was in before committing suicide.
Yeah.
Then okay. She pulls some stuff out her junk.
Yeah, she pulls some stuff out her junk and you get it. So, her mini games that you play to get her, like, junk are notorious in Banjo-Kazooie for being the most fun things you can do.
I think you mean in Banjo-Tooie, because she wasn't in Banjo-Kazooie.
Look, motherfucker.
You should brush
no,
up
they
on
they are
your
that
Banjo-Kazooie
good,
canon.
They retroactively become the best things in Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh, yeah, that's actually what I meant to say. Because as you can see, we're keeping up with her. We can win, right? Oh, you're supposed to be... Oh, no. We're too slow.
I think the first one isn't that hard, if I remember right. Like, it's annoying.
In the mines?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you first race her in a Gutter Gulch mine.
Yeah.
And that isn't too bad. It can be a bit hard, because she rubber band AIs really hard.
Yeah, but it's
so if you
manageable.
If you try to brute force her too hard, you just get your butt kicked. Although in this one, she both brute forces and rubber bands.
So it's also not very long.
Yes, the first one's not very long. The next race is long. Spoilers.
The first one here isn't very long, or the first one in the mine isn't? Because the mine's pretty
Zach,
long.
Is this 1 hour video just trying to beat Canary Mary?
Well, you see. I thought for this finale we would do the I thought we would have the most fun we could possibly do and try and
one
beat
hour of Canary Mary.
Look, she's really hard. She is actually the final boss of Banjo-Tooie. There's nothing beyond this.
Well, I think the game just shuts down when you finish. Hey, you did it.
Yeah, we just need to keep this up.
You just gotta keep it up. I think you will.
Yeah.
Your hands
have been hurting. We still have like 56 minutes, so you know.
That's right.
That is just how long this race is. Even if you do the thing perfectly.
I remember not liking this level that much.
It's a bit weird for a last level.
It's very open and confusing.
Yeah.
Oh, here she comes.
We did it. We beat her. Hooray! Whatever.
Pull that junk out, your junk.
Yeah, let's get some junk.
Now you just have to do that 2 times out of 3.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there's only 2 races.
Oh, okay.
Because this is... She'll give it to us in a second. The last jiggy! Yeah! It came eventually.
Yay.
She just had words to say at us. But she has a papery thing. And don't we want a papery thing?
I think we might.
A book?
Oh, yeah, last jiggy. Here. So let's get the papery thing that we never ever used at all throughout the course of videos of Banjos. Maybe we'll use
a
them
script?
In this one. Yeah, it was a script. Oh. Well, no, we've been using a script this entire time because this is a scripted Let's Play. So the second race, the first race is actually really hard because you can't cheese it because she goes fast. But if you overtake her, she tries to rubber band you. But this one, she's just pure rubber band. So you just take it easy. This is why this video is...
Slow and steady wins the race.
Yes.
Very, very slow and steady.
I think you need to be a little bit... Come on now.
No.
Whoa. You need to be slower and steadier.
You see, if we stay just a tad behind her, we have such a great view of her...
Of her junk.
Yeah, we can see where she keeps her junk. Yeah, I know. I completely agree. Yeah, but Cloud Cuckoo World's a bit of a weird last level, like you said. Because it's big and open, and it can be confusing to navigate if you try to do it the way that they assume you're going to navigate it instead of just using the flight pads to get everywhere like I generally do.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, there's some things you have to navigate as Banjo if you want to get everything. But even then, you know.
then you've got to play as just Banjo.
Yeah, who is the coolest. Where do you stand on who's better, Banjo or Kazooie, Steve?
Well, Kazooie's got the sass, but Banjo's got the class.
Canary Mary's got the ass.
That's right. Mm.
So are you a class?
Windows
or a sass
are made
man?
Of glass. I want to join in on the rhyme.
You know, it's hard, but I think.
Sniffing that junk, by the way.
Yeah, I think that they work best as a pair.
Okay, that's a new original opinion.
Oh God, you're going into her junk.
Yeah.
No, yeah, this is rated M. No one should probably watch this. This is gonna get like taken off of YouTube.
This video is gonna be another 52 minutes of sexy.
Look, this race is really long.
Yeah,
really
this
long.
Is going such a long time.
But now we're gonna overtake her. We're close enough for my endurance to last out to the end.
Are you sure?
Yay.
Well, the problem is that
this is
she
how
just
sex
barely
works.
Overtook me out. No, we won, don't worry.
Oh good.
So we're
slow
gonna
and
get
steady until seconds before the end and then just power through.
Yeah, it's like a basketball game. I assume that's how basketball works. My only experience with basketball is the anime Basquash!
Nice.
And Space Jam.
Oh, yeah.
Please go watch Basquash.
Oh, it's so perfect.
Please.
I want to see a Space Jam Basquash crossover.
George, I lied to you. There is a third race if it was up to Kazooie. Because Kazooie wants to race Canary Mary for her dinner. But Canary Mary's like, nah, I don't want to die. And just flies away. So we get the last thing! We win!
Yeah.
Whoops. That island's shaped like Banjo Kazooie face thing. So now we're back at Spiral Mountain. What can we do with the Cheeto pages, you ask?
What can we do with the Cheeto pages?
I am fucking ecstatic that you asked, because I was. What?
Are you? Like how happy?
Have you ever seen a celebrity put on a fake smile?
Yeah.
It's yes. Nothing like that because... Oh, I missed the jump pad. It's nothing like that because this is pure actual happiness.
Oh, man.
Also, I'm going to pull
you
off...
You mean those fake celebrity smiles aren't actual happiness?
Well, I have actual happiness now. Did you see that pro... beak bomb into the door?
No, I fell asleep halfway through the race.
Oh, well, the race is over. We're talking to a book now. Much more exciting.
Ooh.
Talking to some Cheetos.
So, for every 5 Cheeto pages, you get, which is actually exactly what he's saying, you get a cheat code!
Good!
Yeah, and you can enter them in, and there's a... 5 cheat codes are like feathers, which gives you double red feathers and double gold feathers, and there's eggs, which give you double of all eggs. There's fall proof, so you don't take fall damage, or you could just use the glitch re-ground pound and then you don't take fall damage anyways. There's one called Honeyback where you just regenerate health no matter what. And then the last one's a little bit of a secret.
Uh-oh. A secret.
Yeah.
And it turns Kazooie into Canary Mary.
Damn it, George. I was trying to build Suspendnit's jukebox. But what could jukebox possibly do? Do you guys have any ideas? What can we do with a jukebox?
You can hit it with your fist, go A, and be the coolest kid in 50s high school.
See, this is why I bring on people who've never played Banjo. Because you just fucking ruin it for the audience.
Get out of here, George.
I knew I should have called Adam with Slapdog back. You're lucky I didn't have any money left from the first visit.
How did you get here?
The magic of editing! We walked here and I cut it out in editing because I'm totally playing this right now.
I don't like it.
That's how good an editor he is. He edits real life.
Mm-hmm. So in Banjo-Kazooie, when you wanted to put in a cheat code, you had to go to the sandcastle and type in cheat, then whatever your cheat code was. Well, in this game, they make use of the awesome like first-person shooting, and you peg eggs into the thing. So you still type out whatever you want. Also, I'm a bit of a bad shot, as we know.
It's not the easiest.
Well, I'm also not a good shot, and this is on an Xbox 360 controller. And we know that that thing's not designed for shooters.
No. I don't think has ever been a successful shooter using the Xbox 360 controller.
Yeah, the only way you can make it shooters with a mouse and keyboard. No other ways to do it.
And Wii Remote.
I guess that works too.
And NES controller.
That's also perfectly acceptable. Oh, and 3DS. For the greatest game ever, Kid Icarus Uprising. Second greatest game ever. Oh, also, after you type in the cheat code, you have to turn it on. So it isn't like you only have to type it once. And then
like
you go,
a woman.
Yeah, you type it once and then you just can turn it on and off. And what does the jukebox actually do? Well, if you remember, Jolly had a broken jukebox. Do you guys have any requests?
Don't Stop Me Now by Queen.
Did you say the Glitter Gulch Mine theme?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry,
that's
did you say the old King Cole battle theme?
Yes.
You were reading my mind.
Oh, good. Yeah, so this is just like a sound room. You can come here and listen to all the songs in the game, and you can watch Jolly dance. What's better than that?
Does he do that exact dance no matter what song is playing?
Maybe. He has a sweet spin move, which he didn't do.
Oh. Well, spin.
Oh, look at him go. Come on. Yeah, come on, buddy, spin. Oh, he jumped down.
And he thanks us again.
I think Kazooie knocked him down.
It's a bit of column A, a bit of column B. So!
Oh my god.
So, what do we need to do
to get... These doors aren't going where I think they are.
There's just a few wormholes in this last episode of Banjo-Tooie. It's part of the canon. You would have known if you followed the story. We need access to the final level, right? Well, we gotta do a puzzle.
And you need to do it in 100 seconds.
Yeah, otherwise you run out of witch seconds and...
Quick, get Cory.
She's actually... She can't. Rest in peace, Cory.
Yeah, we heard her die.
Yeah, earlier. It was actually horrible. I don't know why I didn't go to check on her. Steve was pretty worried, though.
I couldn't get there fast enough. Also, I was just pretty worried.
Oh.
Just in general.
I'll keep the body, like, safe for you.
That was the wrong piece. You got the wrong piece.
I know, I'm a fucking idiot. Also, didn't help that AI Banjo's looking off into the sky, which is just brown. That made it a little bit hard, and I'm dumb.
Good.
So we did it. We've beaten the final puzzle of Jiggy Wiggy. Wink.
Wait, wasn't fixing the jukebox, like, the whole point of the game?
Well, yeah, but I'm showing, like, the DLC campaigns.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Do you remember Gruntilda the Witch from the first game?
Was she the mole who, like, taught you how to do stuff?
Yeah, Gruntilda the Witch.
Okay. Sounds right to me.
Well, she's actually the bad guy in this DLC campaign. It's a bit of an offshoot, you know, a bit of a weird thing, but, you know. I downloaded it, figured we might as well play it.
I don't really get it.
Well, it's fine. We don't
need
to
actually... copied my fan fiction!
Well, George, to be fair, you created this game.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that.
Oh, quick heads up. This door's not going to go where you think it is.
Oh, man.
I know. I could have warned you earlier. I'm so sorry. But here we are in the quagmire. So we can get boots. Some sweet sticky shoes.
Stick 'em shoes.
Mm-hmm. They're actually called claw camp clamber boots. Just throw that out there.
Do you know every enemy in this game?
I know that that's a... Ugga? No, I don't. Actually, no. Yeah, I don't. You know how that there was a character parade in Banjo-Kazooie? After you beat Gruntilda's, like, Furnace Fun, it gave credits where it, like, named all the, like, characters.
I vaguely remember.
They don't have one standard in this game. You have to, like, go and check in the options for it. But here we are in Cauldron Keep, the final world. Who is ready for the final challenge? It's going to use all of our powers that we've learned throughout the course, or we can just glitch our way over here by jumping, or you can use the sack pack and do what you're supposed to do. You know, either way works.
Good.
But we have to use ultimate teamwork to get ourselves across this moat of death stuff. And we open a gate, and there's just a laser grid. what are we gonna do?
Tron.
Probably nothing.
We should watch Tron and then figure out what he would do.
I think we should give up.
You know what, Steve?
Oh, go through that big door.
Steve, you're closer on the mark than you probably know. There's a button that you can ground pound as Banjo-Kazooie, like, together to get through. Or you can do the dumb thing and just try to jump through. Because you can jump through if you angle yourself right.
Nice.
There is no...
I thought that the squares looked about big enough for them to fit through, but I also thought there's no way that it would let them get through.
Yeah, I mean, it saves, like, no time whatsoever, because you just gotta, like, walk around the back. So unless you're, like, a speed runner or whatever, or you're just wanted to see if you could jump through or something, I don't know. Oh, yeah, also Klungo. But whatever, who gives a shit?
I do. He's my hero.
Oh. Do you get upset when...
Klungo has a lot of potions.
He does. And we're actually going to see his third and final potion here. And because of how the game randomizes which potions he uses, because he fights differently like each time, we got his weakest potion for his last one. He just gets big.
Good.
And yeah, because when he gets big, he's still vulnerable.
I was hoping that would be how it ends. You just hit him once and then he shrinks.
He's like vulnerable. Oh, but he managed to get me because I did a bad job. Yeah, so this is like is like a really easy one to get for your last one. His aim, how he throws his potions actually changes though. Like the aiming algorithm or whatever they use changes. Because the way he throws in this last one plays more like...
I think I remember that.
Yeah. The last one, he throws more like how Gruntilda shoots in the first game when you fight her.
Quick, wrap the jiggy.
Where's the jiggy?
That seemed like a really hard fight.
Yeah, well, you know, they had to save the best for last.
Oh no, not Mrs. Klungo.
Moment of silence for Klungo, of course.
Of course.
That's probably good enough.
Poor Klungo.
Goodbye, Klungo. Hope you get to make your stupid games.
Oh, he's got a hole in his shirt. Didn't notice that.
Yeah, he gets progressively more beaten up as you go along.
Oh. Now, it's like a metaphor for life.
Are you ready for the real final boss? A quiz game?
Yes.
Well, that's good, because that's exactly what we're going to do.
Are the questions about Zelda and things?
Do you really think that's what the questions are about, George?
It's what I really hope they're about.
Well, you're...
Or the Stanley Parable.
Oh, damn it, how'd you know?
Yes.
Yes, by asking us questions about the not-yet-created Stanley Parable, she will test her Banjo-Tooie knowledge and soundly defeat us, because when this game came out in 2000, you wouldn't know?
I can't wait until Gruntilda the Witch kills her own sisters because of a quiz show.
No. Steve, why would she kill her own sisters? I mean, this is a friendly quiz show. No one's at any risk here.
And wasn't this game based on Game of Thrones? Based on how often the Song of Ice and Fire comes up in these Let's Plays?
Okay. I guess you have a fair point. I was going to try and deceive you, but yeah, it is, George.
Yes.
Yeah, so rather than fighting Gruntilda the Witch, why don't we just settle things with a nice quiz show? You know, non-violent. We've already beaten the crap out of one helpless individual?
I think over the course of the Let's Plays, we've beaten up more than one helpless individual.
Yeah, so we might as well just, like, leave Gruntilda the Witch alone.
Alright.
So you can answer ahead of time before, like, she, like, pulls down the thing and asks you the question. And if you're able to figure it out, good for you. But sometimes she'll ask, like, weird things. Like, she'll show you a picture, and then you just get, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you have to figure out which one's right. But sometimes you get easy ones, and you can figure it out. Like, I saw that grass, and I immediately knew it was Mayhem Temple. Because, come on, what else could it be? Come on.
It could be a field.
No, the only field in the game is in Mayhem Temple. Jesus Christ, George. Weren't you fucking paying attention?
No.
Oh.
Oh. See, you missed one.
You upset me so much, you let fucking, Mingella, or whatever her name is, get it.
Mingella.
I think which is why she just has the hots for her.
To be fair, when Gruntilda introduced her, she was like, my attractive sister.
Mm-hmm. Well, why wouldn't she?
Yeah, so you know what? We'll let Banjo's crush get a few. Just totally not me not paying attention to what the letters were. Or anything. So the quiz game in this,
Wait a minute, Kazooie's whispering in Banjo's ear. That's cheating.
That is cheating.
Well, Blobelda has... or Blob... something has a cat.
What? Cats are fucking stupid. Not like a bird.
Yeah, all birds are smarter than all cats. Everybody knows that.
Yeah, because, you know, birds can fly, cats can't. Therefore, birds are smarter.
It's like how humans have hands. That's why they're so smart.
Mm-hmm.
So, I managed to guess that one, right?
Well done.
When does this game goes on a long time?
Yeah, this is the first round. There are...
Oh, God.
There
is
are
the
three...
last round a race with Canary Mary? Because if it is, I will punch you somehow.
Originally it wasn't, but I never mentioned it up until now, but we're actually less playing my ROM hack of Banjo-Tooie, in which I actually replaced the entire ending of this game with an endless race of Canary Mary. This is the first part of my 207 part series of Racing Canary Mary.
Oh no.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Racing Canary Mary with friends.
Well, yeah, I've actually made it a multiplayer experience.
Yes.
Oh, no.
Of course, we can only play as onlookers, because no more than one other person can race Canary Mary at a time.
You can play as, like, Canary Mary's junk.
Yes.
Yes. I cannot believe how long this quiz is.
Well, yeah, we still have, like, 30 more minutes of quiz to go. I got a question wrong, by the way. I'm a fool.
Monster.
I think you're gonna win this
you're
round.
I had
to restart it. Oh, her name is Blobelda. I actually didn't notice the time. It was gone. I'm sorry, I lied.
Oh, look.
I was trying... Oh, no!
Oh.
What a horrible, unfortunate accident! Well, we'll just move on to round two. We'll ignore what happened, okay?
Which witch gets
squished? Oh, good. I'm glad that round two is as long as the first one.
If it makes you guys feel better, there's nothing you can really do about it in-game.
Yeah, you're right. That does make me feel so much better.
If it makes you feel better, I could have edited this out. But then we would have
missed... That does make you feel better.
But then we would have missed all these questions, and then we wouldn't have been able to get the full Banjo-Tooie experience.
But you could have also hilariously sped it up. That's always funny.
But I don't have the rights to,
slowed it down.
That's a good point.
Wait, no.
You got me, George. The reason and only reason this is taking so long is because I sped it up to 120%, 120%, meaning 20% more than previously existed.
So when you build Lego cars...
I do a damn good job.
I know that one is jingling.
Yes.
You did it. You did it, George. Yes. Good job.
Yes.
Tip-top.
Tip-top has a lot of daughters. You missed Tip-Top. We helped Tip-Top with the miracle of birth, Steve.
You should have helped him with the miracle of winning some races.
Well, Banjo could not help with that one because they're competitors, so you know.
That's true. I always played as Tip-Top. Because he was a turtle and he had a silly voice.
You didn't always play as Banjo because Banjo-Kazooie?
I got Diddy Kong Racing before Banjo-Kazooie, and it was after I had played Banjo-Kazooie, like, a long while after that I realized that they were supposed to be the same Banjo.
Yeah, Banjo made a cameo before he existed to, like, you know, pique the interest of children.
That's right. I like Tip Top better.
You didn't, as a kid, like, see Banjo and have premonitions of the great future that is the Banjo-Kazooie franchise?
I once played a Banjo and got premonitions about bears.
Really?
It might have been because whenever I played it, I got attacked by a bear.
That is so weird that there was Diddy Kong Racing and it featured entirely original characters except for Diddy Kong.
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, that is an improvement to every game, is removing Diddy Kong.
Well, no, Diddy
Kong.
Eat
that little monkey.
Diddy Kong was the only existing character that was in it.
There was also Jindu, the memorable genie Hindu.
Yeah, he was a Hindu and a genie. He was a heenie. That's still the greatest joke I've ever heard in a Bad Abridged series.
It's perfect. Beautiful.
It was perfect. It was wonderful.
6 seconds.
Oh, wait, guys. What if Minjeldu makes a comeback and beats us?
Yes, this last question is worth 1,000 points, making all the other questions completely pointless.
Well, no, we'll, like, agree that it's worth, like, 30 points, like, arbitrarily, even though, like, we have no reason to.
Yeah.
It'll be like the Dark Tournament in Yu Yu Hakusho, which I didn't just recently watch.
Nice.
And I'm bringing up because of that reason. But look, we beat her, so we're the only last contestant remaining on the quiz because of a horrible accident, so we win, right?
No, you still have to, like, get the price right or something.
Yeah, you're right. We have the final round where she changes the rules because we have no one to play against. So she sets a score, and once we top the score, we win, right? So see, if I work quickly, we won't have to wait out the entire timer. How great is that? We can skip some witch seconds.
Sounds good to me.
But Banjo lost her grunty squashed. Are you ready to figure out which? She set a high bar for us with 15 points.
Aw, oh, man.
But I start off by getting -2 points, so maybe we won't make it.
Oh, God.
Because I meant to go back, down. But I accidentally... I did bad. I did bad. I'm so sorry.
What if you get so many negative points that it, like, goes full circle into positive points?
Well, you...
And you win by default?
You would probably win by default, then.
Yes!
I don't know why you posed a scenario where you... with what if, whenever you came up with a solution. George, I'm confused.
Because I didn't think the solution through until I realized there was a solution right there.
Are you guys ready to learn how many entrances there are into Cloud Cuckoo Land Central Cavern? Because I just learned by randomly guessing.
Nice.
I got really lucky with some of my guesses.
Good.
Clearly.
I didn't get that one wrong, by the way. Because I saw the, what's, like, over there, and I was like, oh, it's purple and stars! And then I saw those, and I was like, I panicked, and I didn't know what it was anymore.
Dang.
I was a fool. Also, I actually totally knew that Jet Force Gemini character, because I played Jet Force Gemini. It's actually a pretty good game.
That's what I heard, but I never played
it. The game was, I thought, was okay, but I loved the title.
Jet Force Gemini.
It just rolls off the tongue.
You can also play as a gun dog.
That's true.
Come over to my house, Steve, and play Jet Force Gemini.
Okay, we should play Blast Corps.
I'll stay at my house and just say Jet Force Gemini over and over again.
Also, I lied to you guys. We have to wait out the timer even if we beat her.
You son of a bitch!
I don't know why they do. So you could just wait here and then she'll just skip questions, because if you don't answer, you can skip questions. But I might as well answer them, even though answering them puts me at the risk of getting them wrong and then losing points, and then losing the entire quiz. But we're like hellions. We live life by the edge.
That's right. We're edgy.
Yeah, just like George and Mildred Ice Cube.
Down and dirty.
We brutally murdered a couple in this game, Steve.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're edgy. This is like the precursor to Shadow the Hedgehog.
That is the biggest phrase the Banjo-Kazooie franchise has ever had. The precursor to Shadow the Hedgehog.
The game, not the character.
Well, either way.
Yeah, yeah. No, I was just stating that because there's nothing could lead up to the greatness that is Shadow the Hedgehog. Have you seen how defined his ass is?
Yeah.
Have you seen how much attitude he has? Or how mysterious he is?
Speaking of mysterious, Gruntilda didn't expect us to beat her high score.
That's a pretty high score.
So we've won. There's no more problems. We can claim our revenge and leave without any violence.
Well, good.
Except she's gonna fly away, and we're gonna fight her later. And Banjo and Kazooie like helped her like develop the idea because she was kind of at a loss for what to do.
That's nice.
I feel kind of bad, honestly.
Did she open the door whenever she's already escaped?
So we can go fight her.
Yeah. That was a part of their plan.
He seems to be very casual being under the one-ton weight.
Well, yeah. Because that's never going to drop. It's just going to stay up there because there's no more quiz, so it can't drop.
Oh.
Yeah, even though it's very... Ah! What if we had stayed there 1 second longer? What would have happened? Do you know what would have happened?
I feel so bad that she killed both of her sisters over a stupid quiz game.
I don't blame her. I would murder my siblings. Oh, my... I guess I only have one, but...
Because you murdered the other one.
So we made it to the credits! And unlike Banjo-Kazooie, like, when you beat the quiz show in Banjo-Kazooie, they give you a character parade, and you get to learn everything's name, so you can be like, oh, that's a buzz bomb! Oh! Yay! Gruntlings. Hooray. Oh. Mums.
I'll bet all of these
people. No, that made me angry in the original game, because whenever it was like, this is a flibdaboo, and I'm like, that's not the name I made for it in my head.
I'll bet that all of these people went by these nicknames.
Yeah, like at the office, like, hey, Delberta, hey, Blabelda, get over here.
I don't like that it's Steve is that guy's name. Steve, your new name is Blob Delta.
Oh, man.
Mark Chili Willy.
I want to be Super Stash. Imagine being Super Stash at, like, The Office.
Oh, I'm imagining it.
So,
Oh, man, what about if you were Justin Canary Mary?
Oh, ouch.
Salty...
Mary Maggie. Mary Maggie's a cow, I think. If I had to guess which character that was.
I love how these female nicknames are not for female people.
Well, look. We can either give the female nicknames to the females, or we can pair them up to guys.
Good job, Zach. Wait a minute, were there any females who worked on this game?
Probably. Aren't you reading the credits?
Yeah.
Yes.
I think Rare forbade female employment.
Yeah, here, like, let me...
Hugh David.
Jiggy Wiggy.
Hugh Jiggy Wiggy Ward. Hell, even without the Jiggy Wiggy, he's got a silly name. Hugh Ward.
Nope.
But then they
stopped
giving them names. Well, no more nicknames.
Well, now you're out of the Rare.
Well, that's because you're doing Nintendo staff now. And
yeah, they probably got mad.
Yeah.
Furious.
What do you mean I'm Blabelda?
Sam, Michael, and Chris. Okay, I swear, since I've started paying attention, there's not been one female name.
Yeah, I haven't
I was
seen
paying attention since the start. There isn't a female name, unless you count the nicknames.
The Disciples of Jiggy... Maybe. Disciples of Jiggy Wiggy? Yeah, those could be females.
I think maybe...
How about...
Oh,
how
Evelyn.
About Oh, we did it!
There. Yes, we did it!
Eileen?
High fives all around.
Eileen.
Yes.
I've never heard the name.
Oh, Lay Love Day.
Scroty?
Scroty was a dinosaur.
Scott? No, Scroty is just the name
that was his nickname, and they decided to...
How did they find enough Chris's to work on this game? Because there are a lot of Chris's being credited.
I don't know. So
thanks to the following people: Andy Bottles Wilson, who died along the way and gave us the inspiration for the start.
Kill bottles. Chris Campbell? Huh?
Of Campbell Soup fame.
Oh, yeah.
And Bruce.
So, we should take the time to thank Jackalee? All of you, the viewers. Thank you. Well, now let's take the time to thank George. Thank you, George.
Oh, you're welcome.
Let's take the time to thank Steve. Thank you, Steve.
I don't like that.
Let's also thank everyone else was here.
Gail
Robbie,
Tilden.
Nathan, Ryan, Corey, other Ryan.
That's another
Sam,
girl.
Adam, a slapdog, Jacucci, Cody, Chicken, Cage. Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
Don't thank them. They didn't do anything. They're not here now. The present is what counts.
So actual thank yous to George and Steve. I only gave my half thank yous to the... I'm so sorry.
Oh, wait. Well done for making it this far. Good job, Zach.
Oh, yeah. I'm patting myself on the back there. We made it to the end of the credits, so who's ready for cutscene?
Hot dog.
Hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog.
I think this room was in GoldenEye.
It probably was. Even the Bob control.
Oh, yeah. Exactly, yeah. Like that.
Yeah, with the big red button for blow and the big red button for suck. Okay, so we have dead people on our hands. We have a dead mole and a dead king. What do you guys say?
And two dead ice cubes.
Well, they don't fucking count. We don't care.
Yes, they do. One of them was named George.
Come on, George. Why would we give a shit about a George? You cost me Adam West Lapdog.
He was expensive.
It was well worth my money.
You spent more money than you had. Because of the other things in the contract, you spent more money than currently exists in the world.
Well, it's fine. It was worth it. Thanks. I created my own, American debt.
Well done.
Yes. So, how do you guys feel about necromancy?
Take it or leave it.
Evil Dead would have been a lot worse without it.
It really would have. But we're gonna take it.
Good.
So look, Jiggling's not a zombie anymore, and he clearly favors the Green Jinjos, because he let two of them into his castle. Some, classes bullshit going on.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
Class warfare in Jinjo Village. Also, now that he's alive and all the Jinjos are back, they can go, have a soccer game against the moles. But the moles are also missing a player! I mean, who's gonna be Bottles' replacement? He's dead!
And Kazooie refuses to bring their friend back to life until that mole apologizes to her.
To be
fair, the Dragon Ball franchise could have definitely done with that kind of attitude. Look, come on, everyone, you get one! Fuck you, Krillin.
We'll only bring Goku back to life if everybody on Earth apologizes to me.
Vegeta, stop!
No, they need to say that they're sorry.
Guys, I'm gonna ask the big Banjo-Tooie questions here, though.
Okay.
The gun was only ever used once to drain energy from King Jingling killing him. Bottles was killed by just random Gruntilda magic. Where did they find the energy to revive Bottles if they didn't siphon
the life energy of George and wife?
Okay. We answered that question. Thank you. Also, watch the fish. It blinks.
Okay.
Just throwing that out there.
Everything blinks.
Yeah.
Dead things, living things.
That's also Banjo's pet fish that we saved, by the way.
Good.
He was trapped under a rock. We saved him, released him into the water, only for him to be fished out and eaten by Bottles. After being overcooked.
That motherfucker.
For some reason, this game has incredibly long cutscenes, by the way.
I'm noticing.
Incredibly long cutscenes, but still, not very long dialogue.
Yeah.
It's not dialogue heavy, but it takes a long time.
Yeah, when I first started test recordings for this, when I was watching the opening cutscene, I was like, damn, I think my emulator's running these slow. So I went and watched them on my N64, and they're just this slow.
Yeah.
I don't know what the deal is. I blame the 90s. 90s isn't as good as you remember, people.
What are you talking about?
It's better.
Only 90s kids will remember this. You ever watch Doug? Yeah.
Did any other decade have the Vanilla Ice movie, Cool as Ice?
What about Gushers, Fruit by the Foot? You guys remember jean shorts?
I'm actually wearing jean shorts right now.
Jean jackets.
I wish I was wearing one.
Yeah.
It's been too long since the 90s, and I forgot about them.
Only 90 kids will remember.
Dang.
Remember Dice?
Plus, remember the Three Ninjas franchise, and in particular, Three Ninjas High Noon at Mega Mountain, starring Hulk Hogan, and Three Ninjas?
Remember the Oklahoma bombing?
Yeah, those two things are about equal.
Remember the 90s.
Mm-hmm.
So, we've made it through the cutscenes. Who's ready for a good old case of fisticuffs?
I'd rather see a fight.
Look, we have to talk to Dingpot first. Who remembers Dingpot? Banjo-Kazooie don't.
Do you guys ask, has he appeared in this game up until this point? But
no.
I guess not. Good.
And neither of them remember him.
Well, Banjo's not too smart, and I think Kazooie might remember, but she's vindictive and rude, so I think she might pretend to not.
Oh. Yeah, she'd be like, I won't remember you until you apologize.
So he just, like, fills up all your eggs and your feathers and junk, just so you don't have to go and collect them. Just like something that was before the final boss of Banjo-Kazooie, huh?
Huh?
But there's a gate in our way! How are we gonna get past it, guys?
Jump through it!
Oh, I think I jumped the wrong way.
Oh, no.
Well, thank you guys for coming. I had fun playing Banjo. For some reason, death brought us here! I lied earlier, guys. There's more Jiggy-Wiggy puzzles. There's more Jiggy-Wiggy puzzles
good.
Than we can ever imagine.
Is there any
I can imagine
to get...
three.
Well, then there's more than three.
God damn it. That's a lot of Jiggies.
I know.
Well, I mean, we got 90 Jiggies total, so...
Is that all of them?
Yes, there's 90 Jiggies in-game. For some reason.
That's a
should have put
number.
An extra 10.
Were there 100 in Banjo-Kazooie?
Yes. There are 10 less Jiggies, but this game is, like, 5 times longer.
They should have just put in an extra 11, and then just had you find all, like, the last 11 in the last, like... before meeting the final boss for no reason.
Like when you get to Cauldron Keep, they're just, like, late, like, strewn about, like, randomly. Like, you just walk in
and
you...
Or just in a straight line. He collects them all during the final cutscene.
Now, you don't actually...
It goes up, like, in the top corner!
Do the extra Jiggies actually do anything in this game? Because in Banjo-Kazooie, you needed them to get the extra ending, the secret one.
I don't believe they do anything in this game. Because I had at one point never 100%ed Banjo-Kazooie up until like 5 years ago. Banjo-Tooie, not Kazooie. I always just say Kazooie out of instinct.
I've never been 100%ed Banjo-Tooie.
It happened one fateful day. I went and decided to replay Banjo-Kazooie again, and then I was like, you know what, I'm also going to play Tooie. And I saw my file from childhood, and I'm like, I only have 88 Jiggies. And I went and got them. Because I had never beaten Canary Mary, and I don't remember the other one.
Would have been funny if that beam had just went through the space in between the two beams.
Just missed, and we have to do another puzzle.
Yep.
Yeah, it's a shame that there's not a super special puzzle for the Chosen One or anything. Right?
That is a good thing. What?
That
no!
That has absolutely no reward and extra mechanics.
Zach, why?
Oh, no.
Because it was here, we have to beat it.
No, we don't.
But he dared us. He was like, only the Chosen One can do this. I don't know if he actually said that, but...
But then you can't do it, because there's two of you! You can't be the Chosen One when there's two!
Well, Banjo's the one doing it, because Kazooie's just sitting there, like, watching.
Oh, okay. So it confirms that Banjo is truly the hero of the story.
Yep, in your face, Sam.
Yeah.
You dog-hating son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Dog-hating.
Sam claimed that he hates dogs in one of these. We don't associate with him anymore.
That's okay. I sent him Jerry Rice and Nidus dog football. I think he's cured.
I sent him Kid Icarus Uprising.
That doesn't have enough dogs in it. Or Jerry Rice.
He plays a dog at one point.
Oh, spoilers. Well, that's good. As far as I can tell, you don't play as Jerry Rice in Jerry Rice and Nidus dog football.
According to how much Sam's played, anyways.
Uh-huh.
Also, I'm fucking stupid and don't notice that I didn't tilt it enough. Yeah, so I'm not good at the whole tilty puzzle things, even though that they have this same game in Banjo-Kazooie. As Bottles puzzle thing. Have you guys ever done Bottles puzzle?
Yeah, it wasn't very fun. I mean, it was so much fun.
Thank you.
I went to do it, and then I tried it for like 2 minutes, and I'm like, this is stupid.
You did it. You did one of them. I bet that there's a bunch more.
No, you just do that one. You go for high scores or whatever, I think. Oh.
Wait, did he not even congratulate you or anything?
Nope, there's no reward. He doesn't even say thank you.
That son of a bitch.
He just tells you what your high score is.
He says you truly are the chosen one. So he, like, acknowledges that it was good.
Oh, yeah, I guess. Well, we're on top of Cauldron Key.
Oh, good. And, Canary Rary waits for her final race.
Come on, George. George.
Spoilers. I'm sorry. I knew that because of the novel.
Oh, well, I guess I can forgive you if you've read the novel. But there's nobody up here. Who are we gonna fight if there's not a boss up here to fight?
Canary Mary.
Oh.
In the form of a race.
Where could Gruntilda be?
Yeah, I don't know. Also, I'd like to point out that there's a glass dome surrounding the top of the thing, so she can't fall off of it.
Well, good.
I don't know if the game ever points that out, but I just thought that was, like, such a nice little detail. That she's that afraid of falling off the top of the tower again.
It makes sense.
Is that what license plates look like over there, George?
I don't know. I wasn't paying attention to it.
Oh.
If I see it again, I'll tell you. That's not what regular cars look like over here.
Are you sure?
No. I've never actually been outside.
So, witches are known for fighting in giant mechanical drilling machines, right?
Only when they're skeletons.
I thought it was bitches.
Oh.
Okay.
Here it is. The final boss of the game!
And yes, that is what license plates look like over here.
Okay, cool. I'd always wondered that. So, the final boss also has quiz portions to it.
Oh, no.
Yes!
How great is this video game?
Oh, no.
Also, we were asked that question in the actual quiz show, I believe.
I love how honest she is, just drat. That's correct.
And then you get it right, and she's like, I'll only use my slow spell. And if you get it right, she's like, ha, now I have to use my fast spell. So,
have to.
So this game incorporates the first-person shooter stuff to it. Whenever you get her things right, she stays outside and you can shoot her with the eggs. I prefer to use the normal eggs, because I think they have the highest damage output for this, because you can fire them very quickly, they're plentiful. So I just prefer to use them over, like, grenade eggs, because grenade eggs, I think, are a bit slower. I don't know, I just prefer to use normal eggs. What do you guys prefer to use in your Gruntilda boss fights?
I like using the ones that turn into robots.
I fight her with quiz eggs. Give her a taste of her own medicine.
So, I've actually never tried to fire a Clockwork Kazooie egg up there. I wonder how that would go.
Maybe you'll try this time.
Yeah, maybe I will. The one episode I pre-recorded. The one episode! I was like, nothing can happen in this one that would be out of the ordinary.
Is that a sausage?
Yes, she decides to fire sausages at us. She's trying to fatten Banjo up so he can't get out of the way of the lasers.
Good.
So that he'll have to star in.
That would be a very British way of defeating a bear. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna fatten him up.
Yeah, but it's the canon. This is like a real canon. The canon ending is Banjo just gets fat on that sausage. But then escapes by rolling off the tower because he becomes fat enough to break the glass. shots. Also, you can only do 10 damage to her at a time. There's no point in shooting her past whenever she hits, like, a multiple of 10. Just throwing that out there.
Oh, okay.
Because
Clockwork Kazooie Egg does more damage.
Damn it. Damn it!
Yeah, you'd probably be done with this by now.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It definitely wouldn't have taken, like, an additional, like, 30 minutes or anything.
I think you would have been done with it by now.
I probably would have.
So she's, like, her head is supposed to be a skull. Her bone is a solid chunk of nose. That's pretty scary.
Yeah, well, she's a witch, so. I also like her ribs are really confusing. The thing behind them isn't the back of the cloak. It's another cloak. So she either had, like, a dress inside of her, or she's decided to experiment with her body and has, like, looped clothing through her ribs.
I think that might be it.
I just like to think that she just accidentally ate one of her dresses once.
There are some weird things you can learn about her in Banjo-Kazooie 1. That's a problem with this quiz show. There's not enough arbitrarily randomized grunty questions.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
That's always upset me.
Where is Gruntilda?
She's still in Gruntilda's lair. She never escaped.
Oh, that's a darn shame.
Yeah, which is an extra shame because that place is caved in.
Oh, man.
So she's, yeah.
So all of Grunty's sisters are dead.
Yep. And all of them... Well, actually, Gruntilda's kind of our fault? I don't know? Maybe?
No, I don't know.
Who can say why Gruntilda's lair is all smashed to pieces? They probably tell you, and I don't remember. So who loves Clockwork Kazooie eggs?
I do.
Because we're using them.
She used them earlier.
Well, we're using them now, smartass. Okay? Okay?
I'm just saying.
I'm sorry for yelling.
You broke it.
Yeah, I forgive you.
So we broke one of the batteries in her thing, so it's going to stop working because it needs both batteries, right?
No.
It just has two for some reason. You know, just in case one of them blows up. Also, sometimes she's like a jerk and corners you into the thing, the wall, and then you can't jump over it properly, and then sometimes you just don't push the button in time because you're dumb.
Mm-hmm.
So this is like how she's going to get rack damage up on you. This is her best way to hurt you. For now...
I want to say this fight's easier than the one against her in Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, as a kid, when I first played these games, I could not beat Gruntilda on top of her tower in Kazooie. Like, I had to get my dad to do that for me. But whenever I first played 2, I was able to do this no problem.
But you were older and wiser then.
Yes, 2 years older and wiser. Although now I'm able to fight Gruntilda and Banjo-Kazooie without taking damage, I cannot do the same for this game. Or maybe I can!
Maybe.
Maybe.
I doubt it.
Maybe you will this time.
Yeah.
I'll pick up the health and then it'll, like, start over because I'll have, like, picked up all the health and been fully healed. Because she's nice enough to drop health for you during the final boss fight, just like in Kazooie.
She really is a nice villain.
I like that you said that right as she said, okay, we're gonna fight to the death now.
I think that's an unfair advantage on her end. She is already dead.
Well, we'll make her extra dead. So I, before you start shooting her, when this starts, I like to pick up all the health and get fully healed, because this is gonna be the most relaxing part of this fight you're gonna have. This shit gets hectic after this. Because she's run out of tricks to use with the Hag One, which is the name of the drilling thing. So now she's going to start throwing minions at you. Also, that minion got pretty far in the cutscene. I was really surprised. They normally don't get that far. So I like to...
That's how long these cutscenes are.
I like to line up the shot real nice before starting to shoot. So sometimes I take a while before I start shooting. Also, this one, for some reason, you can take her a bit below the 10 count. I don't know why. I think it's because it stops at 15 or something. So now, the boss fight's gotten even harder! She's releasing cyanide and mustard gas flavored death gas. So now you're choking while fighting her.
That's a shame.
And I'm out of normal eggs, so I gotta switch. And the minions are starting to beat me up. Maybe I'm going to lose this one. Maybe we can't make it, guys. Do you believe Do you believe in miracles?
I believe in the length of the video. I mean, miracles.
I used to believe in miracles, but then I started reading Game of Thrones. Now I just believe in things being cruel.
Speaking of cruel, one health. She has one health left. Now she's gonna just throw her fastest attack. Also, her name's Winky Bunyan. That's her last name. But we can't tell anyone or she'll sue us.
So okay.
Don't tell anybody.
So she thought her last name was Tilda.
Nope. That really quick attack won't kill you in one shot. I always assume it does. But she throws it so quickly, if you get hit, she'll just keep pegging you with it. So if you get hit, you're basically dead.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, and then we won, because she dropped her spell into the thing and blew up. We did it!
But she did not fall off.
No, but she exploded. And as we know, no one survives explosions.
Mm-hmm. Sopping a duck.
Mm-hmm.
Well done.
Yep. Wasn't our party awesome?
Mm-hmm.
Look at all that pizza. But the party started and ended without us. How funny.
Maybe Brunhilde is hanging out with Tootie.
Yeah,
I also
like,
despite the fact that Mumbo and... What's the name of the girl?
Humbawumba.
Humbawumba are supposed to hate each other. They both came together and stood next to each other.
Well, yeah, that's what you do with rivals.
Clearly, they're not rivals. It's sexual tension.
Yeah. Fucking...
No, totally. Mm-hmm. Also, I like that Bottles makes the claim that Klungo ate everything in the house. There are pieces of pizza scattered everywhere.
Those are not pieces of pizza. Those are piles of pizza.
Oh.
Computer piles. Nintendo 64 computer piles.
I'd delete it.
You know, Nintendo 64 could process over 4 piles at any given time.
That's actually pretty impressive.
Maybe 64 piles.
You got it. How many piles do you think the PlayStation can handle?
A station full.
That's right.
Yes.
Which is less than 64.
Yes, I've often been to stations with less than 64 pieces of pizza. Piles.
Piles of pizza.
Yeah, my bad. Well, our party was ruined, but that doesn't mean we can't have fun, right?
Well, yes it does.
Is kick around a thing over there, George?
I think it's just a term for just going out and playing soccer.
Okay, so that actually is a thing. That isn't just like
them threatening
with...
violence.
Although that would be fun. Kazooie is violent, so.
Yeah. Well, but it's a little violent.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Oh.
Yep.
Oh, she's fine. She's making noises.
Yeah.
Oh, she's fine.
No, yeah. Perfect. Peachy.
Grunty cannot. I don't think any character can really die in this game.
Banjo and Kazooie can.
That's true.
The
Bottles was dead for a majority
of
the game.
But he wasn't. Like,
the George and wife have been dead and
that's true.
Didn't even come back in the best in the series.
Her eyeball just fell out.
Oh,
If you can still
talk, she's a skeleton.
Really
she doesn't
dead.
Need those.
Oh, wait, guys. Shut the fuck up!
Oh, okay.
False promises are coming. Banjo-Tooie. Sorry for yelling at you. But the game is over! We did it!
Yay.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, George. Fly on, Captain Blubbers.
Now play Nuts and Bolts.
I will. I will play Nuts and Bolts.
Don't.
Don't, no!